Good morning. Welcome to the civil engineering physics class. It means physics for civil engineering. Today I am going to explain about the first unit, that is thermal performance of buildings. Thermal performance of buildings, unit number 1. The subject is physics for civil engineering. So first, thermal performance of a building. In this particular one, the some technical terms, some important terms are there. In that one, the fenestration, the first term is fenestration, about the fenestration. So this lesson basically deal about the thermal performance of a particular building, how the building is going to be reacted when the heat which is come from the outside and also from all the different wall, both the top and sideways, so in different place or different part the heat is enter into that building by the way of window or the door and so many openings. So the what's the reaction of the particular building for that particular heat? So this all is going to be dealt in this particular unit. So this is fully related to construction, a particular building, how to react it with that heat which is come from the environment. So based on that, how you are going to build a building for thermal comfort, that means a person who are staying inside the building is going to be feel a comfortable position, in that such a way the building designs would be made. So these all going to be discussed in the particular unit. So the first one is fenestration. So what's the term fenestration means? The fenestration is defined as any opening or that is arrangement of opening in a building. Whatever the opening is available in our building, that under this fenestration. What's the meaning of fenestration? Fenestration is nothing but any opening or the arrangement of the opening through which the light is going to be enter into the building. That is the arrangement of opening and also any opening in that building. So various fenestration systems are, that is in our building, the various fenestration systems are, that is window and also the different doors, different type of doors, and also exterior doors, glazing. These all are the component of this fenestration. So already explained what is fenestration. It is nothing but any kind of opening or the arrangement, that is opening arrangement in a building through which the light enter into the building. So what are the possible opening in a building? That is maybe in the form of windows or in the form of door and glazing. So these different, so etc. Different possibilities are there. Even ventilation also. Okay, then main component of this fenestration. Fenestration, the three main component of fenestrations are glazing, then also framing, siding devices. Glazing, then framing, and also siding devices. Glazing means the nothing but the arrangement, that is glass through which light which enter into the building, that is glazing. Then framing, that nothing but the part which hold that glass, framing, and siding devices, the sun shade, everything. So these all the component, the main component of the fenestration. So already teach what is fenestration, then what about the different components of the fenestration. So this is related to a building where the light entering amount is going to be desired. Okay. Then glazing, the first component. We're going to discuss about the first component, that is glazing. It is a main part of fenestration that let light through, and it usually glass. It's nothing but glass through which light may enter into the building. So that is a glazing. It's an arrangement. Arrangement. Glazing is an arrangement that is actually is made up of glass through which the light may enter into the building. That is the next. Already I explained framing. It is a material that to hold the glazing in a place. That is just frame. Frame that hold the glass in the particular place. That is a framing, supporting part of the glass. Then the shading device. So unit may or may not have shading devices. It is used to avoid incident of light directly on the glass. So the main purpose of keeping that sunshade is to avoid the direct sunlight entrance into the house. So the same way here also, the shading device whose main purpose, the unique purpose of the shading device is avoid the incident light directly into that glass. So the arrangement of glass is there, that glass, the direct sunlight incident is going to be avoided by using this shading device. So these all the component, the main component of the fenestration. Then how the heat transfer through this fenestration. That means how the heat is entering into the building through this fenestration. Fenestration nothing but the opening or the arrangement of opening through which light enter. So how the heat transfer through fenestration? Heat transfer through this fenestration by this way, that is thermal heat due to thermal effect, and heat that is due to solar. Solar means that means the sunlight. Thermal means that is nothing but heat transfer between indoor and outdoor, air blow. The air blow which is carrying heat from one place to another place. That particular one is actually denoted by Q thermal. And Q solar is nothing but heat transfer from the solar radiation. That means direct sunlight entrance. So it's maybe enter this. This is a two possible way of light entering into the building. That is direct sunlight entrance, or it is the transfer of heat by the movement of air blow. That means indoor outdoor air blow. So this is a way of heat transformation through this fenestration. Fenestration means arrangement of opening through which the light enter. The heat transfer through fenestration consists of two component, that is Q thermal and Q solar. What does mean by Q thermal? That is Q thermal nothing but a heat transfer between indoor and outdoor air blow. So maybe the possibilities of outside air entrance into or entering into the interior part of a building, by this way a heat transformation may be taken place. That is Q thermal. Then the another one way is without, if there is no glazing or such arrangement, there may be a direct sunlight entrance. So it's possible through, if a building have number of doors, it is possible the light entrance into the building without any glazing arrangement. So that is Q solar. So total heat transfer through this fenestration. So the method of heat entering into a building is a combination of the Q thermal and Q solar. That means through some part the direct sunlight may enter into the building, through some part the heat transfer by the way of air blow. So the sum of the two, that is responsible for the heat entering into a building, that we called, that is total heat transfer through the fenestration. That means amount of heat that enter into the building through the various fenestration component like the window and doors like that. Okay. So this is a method of, so if you are asking the question, how to find the total amount of heat that entering into the building, it is very easy to find that the sum of the heat that is due to the air blow between this indoor and outdoor part, and the direct sunlight which is come from the sun. This is a two component through is going to be added for finding the total heat entrance into the building by the way of fenestration. Okay, then next, this is a technical term, fenestration. Building construction is a very important one. Buildings should be constructed in such a way that a large amount of light is going to be enter into the building, so that the building is going to be in a bright one, and also is a comfortable one, because air blow is also easily available. Air blow is a very important one. That is a main thing where the person or the human being is going to be live in a comfortable position. That is a thermal comfortable of a human body. So for these all, the thermal fenestration, that's a technical term. So building construction time, you must remember the word fenestration. So whether the building have adequate number of that means window, and also corresponding that is door for entering a light, and also a person. That's all. Then there is a fenestration. Now I move to the other part, that is thermal insulation. So thermal insulation, that is also a very important part the building construction, because in the summer time, most of the heat is directly enter into the building by all these surrounding. So it should be avoided for the thermal comfort. For that, the thermal insulation technique is going to be implemented. So nowadays, the thermal insulation is during the concrete construction time itself, they may put the thermal insulation, they use thermal insulation method in order to keep that building is always a cool one in both the summer and also winter time. So that's the insulation. So how we are going to insulate the building, avoid the direct sunlight and also more light entering into the that means the building. That is a thermal insulation. So there is a particular definition. A thermal insulation is the process of resist the flow of heat. So that's already explained. This resist the flow of heat, that can be done with the help of the insulator, insulating materials can use during the building construction, particularly in the concrete construction time. Okay, so thermal insulation is a process of resist the flow of heat, and that means to and also into the body. It is material that reduce the rate of heat flow. So the material is going to be reduce the rate of flow. That is also thermal insulation. So the thermal insulation should be used in all the building in order to better, that means comfortable building or comfortable position or comfortable one for the living beings, that means particularly in human beings. So thermal insulation. So these all about the beginning of, that means some important terms of this particular unit. So once again I just revise that. So this is a unit 1, that is thermal performance of building under this subject. That is subject code is PH8201, physics for civil engineering. So only for civil engineering student. Then here I am going to explain some important terms, technical terms, and the particular civil engineering student that they use this particular term. That is, the first one is fenestration. What is fenestration? Fenestration is defined as any opening or arrangement of opening in a building. The various fenestration is there. The example is that means window and also door and glazing and all. Then main component of that means fenestration, I already discussed in the three component. Then about how to calculate the heat entrance into the building, that is Q thermal plus Q solar, in such a way you can find out. Then total heat is going to be find out. Then at last, thermal insulation is a process of resist the flow of heat to and from the body. That means the entrance of heat into the building, that should be avoided, and once entered, heat is going to be avoided to come out. So such a two way is going to be possible. Insulation means the heat already exists inside the building is not allowed to go out. The similar same time, the heat which is come from that surrounding is also going to be resisted. So such a device is going to be built in a building in order to avoid this overheating during the summer time. That is a thermal insulation. So these are the some terms that is related to the unit one. So I continue this in the further video. Now, okay, thank you.